Opa!
It was this unexpected performance that has so staggered Russian viewers. The country's tightly controlled TV channels usually stay well away from lampooning the Kremlin, the singing and dancing president and prime minister joking about corrupt officials and gas pipelines. Was unthinkable until now. Backstage, the creators of the show, broadcast on state television, use state-of-the-art graphics to bring their animations to life. But it's the choice of subject matter that's the real virtual revolution. Even though scripts poke only mild fun at Russia's powerful, in a country where Kremlin critics are often silenced, the show's producer must be taking a risk.
When you write your scripts, yeah. I mean, do you have to give them for approval to anybody in the government to make sure they don't offend
not
anyone?
Not even to the general director, you won't believe me. Sometimes he first see and hear it in the air.
But are you concerned, as the producer of this show, that one day you may overstep the line with somebody like Vladimir Putin and the show will be closed down and somebody will be offended?
No, I don't believe in this. No, because he has a great sense of humor. I don't think that if we are funny, really, he won't be offended, I'm sure.
Putin and his presidential successor, Dmitry Medvedev, are now regular characters on the show.
Thing is, for years, satirical images of Russia's leadership have been almost completely absent on the nation's television screens. So the sudden appearances of people like Dmitry Medvedev, the Russian president, has been something of a big surprise. It's also raising questions about whether the Kremlin is finally relaxing its tight grip on the country's media.
The Kremlin has bitter experience with satirical puppet shows. The fiercely critical program Kukli routinely ravaged Putin during his early years as president. The show was eventually taken off the air as the Kremlin established media control. Critics say the new digital show is soft in comparison.
It imitates political satire. It's not real political satire, but it is trying to send a message to the public and to the world that we are changing. Something is changing in Russia. In fact, political reform is not happening.
But this may be a small step. Satire has a way of building momentum. Even a small dose can be dangerous. Matthew Chance, CNN Moscow. Зависть.